Sega Saturn, Shiro. Sega Saturn, Shiro. Sega Saturn.
Good day, guys. Oster here. And in this one today, we're getting stuck straight back into a little bit of Sega Saturn. Now, you guys watched my video the other day and you kind of loved it. You had a lot of feedback and many of you wanted to play Sega Saturn on your PCs. Well, there's lots of options available to you and we're going to talk about them all in this video today. I'm also going to take you through setting this up exactly as I did the other day, except this time on a PC. So you know exactly how to work this emulator and know all the information about all the other emulators so you're ready to rumble. However, if you're just here to watch the tutorial, I'll put links straight to it in the description down below and you're good to go. Other than that, let's get stuck in. So you want to play Sega Saturn on your PC? Well, it's a good day indeed because, like we talked about, we're going to get it up and running today on our PCs. Now, there are various different emulators that you can use to emulate Sega Saturn, and I'll talk about more about that kind of stuff at the end of the video and while I'm showing you this one. Because this is, for me, a very good option nowadays, especially for lower powered computers. The other options are very highly powered. In other words, you need a very good PC in order to run this very old system, or they're not very compatible. And again, we'll talk about that more at the end. But for now, I want to get you set up with Yabousy, the one that I covered the other day on the video. Now, on that video, I was covering more single board computers. I was talking more low-end devices, such as Android phones, ARM devices. You can play it on near enough anything. That's the great thing about Yabousy. I did give a link in that video, but it was guiding to the website, which you may have thought may have misled you, but it's not. It is actually the website that I wanted you to go to, and I'll explain that now. Okay, this is the official website for Yabousy. Now, this isn't the one I linked, but is the official one. If you was to Google Yabousy, this is where you would go. Now, in here, as you can see, the right-hand side, the last update was 2016. It's a very dated version of this. It's the original. Nobody's bothered with it in some time, which is a shame, to be honest, because it did make a very promising start. It's just that the other emulators overtaken it, and this one kind of fell off the radar. Now, the great thing is that this is open source, or anybody can contribute, anybody can add, anybody can do anything they want to get this up and running and help the scene out. It's also, unlike the other emulators, available on different platforms, like we talked about, single board computers, Odroid, possibly the Raspberry Pi in the future, who knows. Also available on Mac, Windows, Dreamcast, Linux, pretty much anything that you can throw at it. It's a very compatible emulator that can be played on very different devices. But as we talked about, the last update was 2016, which is useless to us because it's gone a lot further since then. Now, in the description down below, like the one I did link in the video, is this, the OU Yabousy. It's a fork from the original. Now, this is an awesome one, and if you was going to download it on a Play Store, this is the one that you would get. Also, it's the one that was forked over to the Odroid, the one that I was actually showing in that video. And yes, you can play it on Windows. It says here at the top, which is kind of misleading, the fact that this project is focused on the Android version of Yabousy, which it is, theoretically. But there are also forks for the Windows version. If you go to the Downloads tab at the top here, and you scroll down, these are all the Google Play stuff. As you can see, we've got the Windows version. This version is called Yaba Sanshiro, which is the forked version for Windows. That's the one that was forked over to the one that was on the Odroid, which is awesome. Great news. And everything that was featured in that video will be more or less identical to the kind of gameplay that you would get using this emulator, if not better, because you're using the extra grunt from your PC rather than a single board computer. So if you want to get it up and running using this emulator, that is the one to choose from. Now, the great thing is that because it is PC, there are other options available to us even more than this. So this is the official one, and I would go for this if I was you, but there is also another choice which is almost identical, but it's breaking through even faster. This one was released on the 5th of the 5th, 2018, but in the description down below, I'll also guide you to this place here, which is the GitHub for FKers Yabousy. Now, I believe this is called Kronos. and basically he's forked away from the Devi Mayak's build, in other words the Sanshiro, and also it's forked from the original Yabushi. So he's taken all the best bits, he's put it all together, and he's added his own spin on it. Now there's not much that can be done from the official GitHub, because unless you know what you're doing when you build GitHub actual files, but someone on the internet has done it as always, and they've actually built it. So again, I'll put links in the description down below to this website here, which is emutalk.net, a good little forum as well, by the way, guys. And he's a French guy, I believe I translated this page, and basically he's put all the information that you need to know. There's no official site for it or anything like that, all I can find on the tinterwebs is this official build from them. Now, I believe somewhere else here is given advice as to what is actually done in this version, which differs from the others. So he's added more support for Windows, added support for STV games. These are the arcade variations of the Sega Saturn games. Some of the games do use this kind of engine to run, so they can become problematic, which means that with the Zeppelin support from this emulator, you'll probably get more compatibility. Also is included extra resolutions, extra upscaling, filters, all that kind of stuff, which is absolutely fantastic. He's got a Kronos interpreter, which he's rebuilt, less CPU usage, awesome. He's fixed some graphical problems, and there's more options for your video, which is great. So what we're going to do is actually install this one today. So again, in the description down below, guide you to this section of this website, all you need to do is click on it. This is almost identical to the OU Yabushi as well, by the way, guys. So if you have no luck with this, go to the other or vice versa. It's all down to personal taste. I like the added features of the graphical options on this one. That's the only reason why I'm showing you this one today, as it's a little bit different. So what I want to do is, it's a compressed file. Once it's downloaded, I want to extract these files into a folder. So I'm going to make one now. It's called it Kronos. Can't spell it. Kronos demo, just so I know which one it is. I'm doing it on my desktop, so it's easy for you to show you guys. I would hope that you put this somewhere on your PC, which is, well, better suited. Then all I need to do is highlight all the actual files and folders, drag it over to the folder that I've just made, let it run free and do its bits and bobs. Now I can get rid of the compressed file, don't need that anymore, and open up what we've just uncompressed or extracted, whatever it is you want to call that. Now, in here is all the different files and folders. We don't need to bother about any apart from this one, Kronos, and it's even got the official Yabushi icon. Now, the good thing about Kronos is that it actually has a emulated BIOS within there. You can also use an official BIOS. You can dump them yourself, you can get them from websites, there's even homebrewed versions. Now, when I've tried region-free BIOSes, I have had problems. I wouldn't say that's 100% with this emulator, but I would say that official ones seem to run perfect for me, and of course the emulated one, I've actually not had any issues with it. So for this purpose today, I'm going to show you the emulated BIOS. It will get better compatibility with official ones, but that's up to you to go down that route. I'll show you now anyway. So all you need to do to get it to run is double click it, go on to file to set up our options, go into settings, and here's all the options we've got available to us. First one in there is BIOS. If you've got your own BIOS, they normally come in .bin format. All you need to do is click on these three dots and find the location of wherever it is your BIOS is. Once it's done, click open and it will put the location there. If you haven't got a BIOS or you want to use the internal BIOS, the one that comes with it, all you need to do is tick that box. That is it. Next thing then, I would tick this. Basically, the Saturn had a clock on it, which basically knew what time it was to save your games and all that kind of stuff. I would click on synchronize so it knows exactly what time it is from your system. I would also click on auto start, so when you load a game, it automatically starts it running. And the rest of the stuff you don't even need to mess around with. Obviously, the number of threads at the bottom here depends on what kind of PC you're running. My specs are in the description down below. I've got 12 cores, which isn't needed at all for this emulator, but it's in there anyway. Next video, and nothing to mess around with here. Once we get in game, we will start messing around with some of these settings to actually give enhancements to us. But for now, leave everything as stock while we're just testing stuff out. Stock. Sound, leave everything as it is. Cart memory on cartridge, do down the drop down box, go to DRAM, 32 DRAM. Now, the Sega Saturn itself, it had various cartridges that you could plug into the console. Some of them gave extra backup for your save games and stuff. In other words, extra memory for your save games. There was an action replay that you could go in there to do your cheats and stuff. Not very useful for emulation, but you can still do it. We don't really need the extra save games because it does it on its own anyway in the emulator. So the most useful one for us is 32 DRAM. This added power or grunt to some games that could be emulated through the Sega Saturn. Not all, but it's best choice to choose it. So those games that are using it, you've still got it enabled. There was one game, I believe it was one of the King of Fighters, that needed the 16 ROM. And, well, I don't even think you need it on this. But for me, I would choose this one, so you're good to go. Obviously, if you're loading King of Fighters and it won't work, choose the other one. It's not rocket science. Then go into input, this is where you do your pads, and you can choose different versions of the controllers that were available for the Saturn. For this one, I'm going to choose the pad and just quickly set this up. Obviously, my controller is slightly different, so just fiddle through and do whatever button layout works for you guys. Click on close, and then that is the pad set up. Obviously, if you've got more than one player, you can do all those, but for me, I am good to go. Next, advanced region, go onto auto detect, no need to mess around with that. These are for the sound and the CPU interpretation. And view, yep, no need to mess around. And these are the shortcuts if you want to basically use shortcuts. Click on OK. Next thing then, click file, and we want to load a game to test it out. So I've got a few games here which we're going to test. And first up, let's do a bit of Panzer Dragoon. So all you need to do is this, if it's mounted to a drive, or if you've got the disc in a drive, you can load it straight from there. This one, if you want to load it from an actual file or ISO. So click on this, find out where my games are. So for me, it's desktop, Sega Saturn games, and like I said, we're going to do Panzer Dragoon. And you want the Q file, because I've already got VLC, it automatically picks up that this is a VLC file. It's not, your icons may differ, but bin and Q are normally the format that you get for Sega Saturn. Sometimes you've got CCD and sometimes you've got CHD. As far as I'm aware, they're all compatible with this emulator. Just choose one, and if it doesn't work, choose the other file that comes with it. So click on that. And now, because we clicked auto start, it should, hopefully, start playing the game once it's configured itself to our system. Come on. Oh, we have to click start. So now it should click the game. There we go. So as you can see, we're now playing Panzer Dragoon Saga, which is absolutely awesome. Now what we need to do is get the screen bigger so I can see what's going on. You can full screen this, but I need to have my options available to us. Then, because I've done my controller, we can skip through all this. And then I'm going to click on continue. I have got a save game in here, thank God. And now, as you can see, we are in game. And my controller's working. We are pretty much good to go. Amazing. Now, because we are playing this for the first time, none of our settings have been messed around with, like we talked about just a second ago, because we left everything as default. But because we're playing this through our PC, we've now got the added power that we can add to it, so we can start to enhance things. So first off, emulation, file settings. What we want to do is video. Now what we want to do is do the size. We'll bring that up to 2x resolution. And we will do the triangles using perspective correction. I would keep to that. If you're getting warped textures on your game, try moving these around. Normally the perspective correction works in everything, but if it is using any trouble, I would go to either this or GPU. GPU is going to be the fastest, that one's going to be the most accurate, that one hopefully should fix everything. Upscale filter, I would go for either bilinear or bicubic, depending on what's working for you. I'm going to go for bicubic. And then you've got the filters that you can do for the upscaling. So this is more for your textures. So things such as writing and actual 2D assets on the screen, even if it's wrapped around a polygon or something, this is what will give that kind of feature. These sometimes look a bit paintbrush effect, a bit rounded in sometimes, and can be a bit off-putting. So be a bit careful when using these. For just this video, I'm going to choose 4x BRZ, and I don't want to do no TV effect, and off we go. So now, as you can see, it looks a lot better. And you can go through your different options you've got within there. Choose a different tessellation, choose a different upscaling, choose different resolutions to whatever you like the most. But you can see now, as we're going in-game, with that upscaling, around the writing, you've now got that kind of paintbrush or watercolor effect going on. So if I was to go into settings again, video, and turn off this 4x BRZ to none, I will get the upscaling, but I would get more pixelated rather than rounded paintbrush effect that's going on. So wait for the writing to come back. You see how things are more pixelated now rather than rounded off around the edges? That is that because it's not got the 4x BRZ on. And again, it all down to your personal taste. If you want things to look smoother, rounded. For me, I do like a better resolution, but I don't want to take away from the actual aesthetics of the original game. That's just me, my personal interpretation of it. That's why we've got these options available to us, and that's what makes things amazing about emulation. So I think we've covered the actual emulator itself. Now what I want to do is quickly talk about the reason why I'm showing you this emulator rather than the others. First, because it sparked interest from you guys looking at the actual emulator being played through the single board computer. You wanted to be able to play it on your actual systems. And one of the reasons why is because the other emulators, such as Mednafen is the best emulator to choose out there for Sega Saturn emulators. It's awesome. It is absolutely outstanding at what it does. It's the most compatible, it's got the best performance, and it's the most accurate emulator you can choose for Sega Saturn emulation. The problem with it is that it is very system intensive. You need a beastly CPU in order to run Mednafen, especially the Sega Saturn, and especially on very 3D intensive games. You will get half speed even on, well, a few months ago I tried it on an i3 Coffee Lake and it was brand new straight out of the box. Everything was good, it was all set up properly. I was getting half the speed compared to my proper rig. Now yeah, i3s are pretty low end-ish, but you would expect at least a 90s console to be able to play to its utmost. But that's nothing against Mednafen. Their biggest thing is accuracy. And to get that kind of accuracy needs a lot of gruntage in order to replicate the gameplay as it was. So I don't blame them. It's just that Mednafen is the best option. But it's not for everybody because not everybody has got the PC to run it. So that's why I was showing you Yabousi, because everybody should be able to run that because you can even run it on pretty much anything, including a single board computer. Now there are other options out there as well. We've got SSF and that's awesome. But the thing is, SSF, it's limited in its compatibility. It's not as intensive as Mednafen, but it's not got the compatibility with the games as Mednafen. So you may as well either go to one extreme or the other. And the other thing with SSF is that it was fussy with its file formats. You needed to mount the discs on a drive in order to run the actual games, which is a pain in the ass. So it kind of put itself out the market. Now Mednafen itself, there are other versions available for it. You can load it through RetroArch, I believe it's called Saturn Beetle on there, and it is great, it's fantastic. If you can get your head around RetroArch, then you're good to go. The thing is that not only was it as intensive as the original Mednafen, but also in most cases even more, because you are adding extra graphical features using RetroArch, and that puts your strain even more onto your PC, which isn't ideal when it's already under a lot running these older games. But it is a valid option for those people with the PCs who can run it. Now if you do want to run standalone Mednafen, it's a pain in the ass. There's no GUI for it, there's no menu, it's hard to run out the box. It needs command prompts and it needs shortcut keys. But I have put a video, it was out some years back, I'll link it in the description down below, and it will show you exactly how to run Mednafen to its utmost using the standalone emulator, even without the GUI. It's not hard to follow, it's just a case of setting it all up, then you're good to go from that day forth. Now, in that video, I said that it was only US games. Now the compatibility is extended, and now you can run games from any region, which is awesome. But I do need to say that it is a pain in the ass, and it's very system intensive. So now I think we have covered near enough everything to do with Sega Saturn emulation. I think we're up to speed, everyone is good to go. You know how to run the emulator that I was talking about the other day. We've cleaned up a few facts, and well, Sega Saturn is now running to the maximum for everybody, depending on what kind of system you guys are running. So, as always, guys, it's been an absolute pleasure bringing this to you. But as always, guys, this has all been possible thanks to the Patreon supporters. Now, I'll put links in the description down below if you want to join the club, but it's thanks to them that I'm able to make videos like this and bring this kind of information to you guys. Hopefully in the future we'll extend this even more and we'll start going into bigger systems and we'll start to push emulation even more to the maximum that we've even been doing up to now. But again, I have to give my solid thanks to everybody who supports me on the... Well, that's about it, guys. Thank you very much for joining me. Please, as always, like, subscribe, do all the magical things that you could ever imagine in this wonderful world where we get to play a 90s-based console on a 2018 computer that is pushed to the absolute limits, unless you watch my video. But most of all, you guys have a good day. Laters!